branch. Today we will discuss about logarithmic differentials. Now, what is logarithmic differential? Definition is the method of differentiating a function after taking logarithm is known as logarithmic differentials. Derivative of exponential and logarithmic functions are different. What logarithmic differentiation is? It is a process. It is a process in which we are finding the derivative after taking logarithm on both sides. Now, when we will take log on both sides? There are only. When it is applicable. The answer is the logarithmic differentiation is applicable. First is if the function is product of more number of functions, that is for y equal to x minus a into x minus b into x minus c into x minus d, like this. Or if the function is the product of more number of functions, that is y equal to x minus a into x minus b into x minus c into x minus d by x minus e into x minus f into x minus d into x minus f, etc. Or I if the function is of the form u to the power d, where both u and d are functions of x, that is y equal to, suppose log x to the power sin x, etc. So if the function is in any of these three forms, then generally we use logarithmic differentiation. Okay. Now, how to differentiate? The process is, here the step, first step is, if the function is in any of the above three forms, then take logarithm on both sides of the function. This is first. It is in this form, and first of all you will take log on both sides. Then second step, simplify the function using laws of logarithm. Okay. After taking log, you will simplify them using these laws of logarithm, such as first law of logarithm is log x y, it will be equal to log x plus log y. Now log x by y, it is log x minus log y, and log x to the power y equal to y log x. And third is, then take the derivative on both sides to get the result. So these are the three steps in logarithmic differentiation. First we will take logarithm on both sides, then apply laws of logarithm, and then differentiate. Okay. But here one point you have to remember. Note that when the function is expressed as a sum or difference of two or more function, then never take logarithm on both sides. So when the function expresses the sum or difference, then never take logarithm on both sides. In this case, we find that individual compile them, because log x plus or minus y is not equal to log x plus or minus log y. So log x y is log x plus log y. That's why if the function is in product form, we can take log on both sides. But if it is in this form, x plus y or x, we cannot take log, because if we take log, then it is not log x plus log y or log x. That's why this point had to be removed. Now let us solve few problems. But if it is in first to take log, one shortcut method to find the derivative of third type form, which is in exponent form, is like this. This is node 1 you take, then node 2, 2, find the derivative of u to the power v, where both u and v are functions of x, remember the formula d by dx of u to the power v equal to u to the power v into d by dx of v log. Okay, derivative of u to the power v same function first into derivative of here you log of logarithm v log. How will you prove it? You see, proof is like this. Suppose let y, y equal to u to the power v. Now since here both are functions of x, we will take logarithm first. We can write log y equal to log u to the power v. Now what we have written here? After taking logarithm, simplify using log of logarithm. Now it is in third form, log x to the power y is y log x. So here right hand side you can write, this is v log u. Now after simplification, third step is then take derivative on both sides. Now we will take derivative d by dx of log y is equal to d by dx of v log u. Now what is derivative of log y with respect to x? Implicit function. So derivative of log is 1 by this, so it is first 1 by y, and since it is implicit, we will multiply dy by dx, 1 by y dy by dx equal to d by dx of v log u. Now we want to find what? Dy by dx. So dy by dx equal to y will be multiplied here, y into d by dx of v log u. Okay. Now what is y? Y is this square, this one, u to the power v. So it is u to the power v into d by dx of v log. Now you see this one. Derivative of, so that's why instead of doing this much, if you will remember this formula, then easily you can solve any function of logarithmic differences. Okay. Now let us solve your example. Example number 1. Differentiate the following with respect to x. First formula is, that is x minus 3 into x square plus 4 only 100 cx square plus 4x plus 5 whole root of b right x to the power x c cos x to the power x. Okay. Then next is x to the power x square minus 3 plus x minus 3 whole to the power x square. So x is greater than 3. Okay. First, let us solve this. Here, solution. First, we will take let y. Okay. Let y is this. X minus 3 into x square plus 4 whole divided by 3x square plus 4x plus 5 root of. Now taking if we take log because it is in that form. So log y equal to log x minus 3 into x square plus 4 by 3x square plus 4x plus 5. Now square root is there when your power is 1 by 2. Now we will apply log of logarithm. This implies log y equal to, it is in the form of log x to the power y. So log x to the power y is y log x. So you can write half log x minus 3 into x square plus 4 by 3x square plus 4x plus 5. We have used third law of logarithm. Now again, we have to simplify it. Now it is in the form of log x by y second form. So again you have to simplify. This is half log numerator x minus 3 into x square plus 4 minus log y denominator log 3x square plus 4x plus 5. This equal to half of. Now again it is in the first term, so here we see. In this problem, we have used all three laws of logarithm. First, your third rule, third law. Then here, second law. Now we are going to first law. T in the form of log x, so log x by log x plus log y. That is log x minus 3 plus log x square plus 4 minus log 3x square plus 4x plus. Now we take derivative on both. Then d by dx of log y. This is half of d by dx of log x minus 3 plus log x square plus 4 minus log 3x square plus 4x plus 5. Now this is 1 by y into d y by dx half. Now here we look chain rule. First it is derivative of log x. Derivative of log x is 1 by x. So 1 by x means 1 by x minus 3 into derivative of x minus 3. That is 1 plus. This is 1 by x square plus 4 into derivative of x square plus 4, derivative of x square plus 4 is how much? 2x. That is 2x by x square plus 4 minus. Here, derivative of this is how much? 3x square is 2 into x square is 2x, so 2x into 3, 6x plus 4 by 3x square plus 4x plus 5. This is 1 by y dy by dx. So dy by dx equal to y into this, so y by 2 into 1 by x minus 3 plus 2x by x square plus 4 minus 6x plus 4 by 3x square plus 4x plus 5. So this is y value, again you have to write, so it is half of x minus 3 into x square plus 4 by 3x square plus 4x plus 5 whole root of, this is y into 1 by 2 into 1 by x minus 3 plus 2x by x square plus 4 minus 6x plus 4 by 3x square plus 4x plus 5. This will be the answer. You have to leave the answer in this. Here. Now, second, x to the power x. Derivative of x to the power x. Now, here I am using the direct formula. It is not form of u to the power v. So, u to the power v. Derivative is what? U to the power v into derivative of v log u. So you can write the x to the power x into d by dx of x log x. So once again I am writing as d by dx of u to the power v equal to u to the power v into d by dx of v log u. So this is x to the power x. Into, now here we will use product rule. So dx by dx into log x plus x into derivative of log x with respect to x, that is x to the power x into, it is 1 into log x plus x into 1 by x, this is x to the power x into 1 plus log x. This is the derivative of this. Now third is derivative of cos x to the power x. So there also you can use chain rule. You see, find derivative of cos x to the power x with respect to x to the power x. First function you write 2x. Now I take chair rule, derivative of cos theta with respect to theta is minus sin theta. So minus sin x to the power x into derivative of x to the power x. Now we have proof this value. That's why I am not again giving the proof. Direct I am writing the real. Here it is x to the power x into 1 plus log. You see here. Okay. Then D. D is that form. That note I have written, if the function is expressed as the sum or difference of two or more functions, then we cannot take logarithm on both sides. And this is an example of that type of function. So here we have to find their individual derivative. So here we write like y equal to x to the power x square minus 3 plus x minus 3 to the power x square. Okay. Again, let us take u equal to x to the power x square minus 3 and v equal to x minus 3 to the power x square. So, what will be the value of y now? Y equal to u plus v. Now if we take derivative on both sides, dy by dx, it will be equal to du by dx plus dv by dx, that will be our first equation. Now I will find this individual. Now u equal to x to the power x power minus so this implies du by dx the direct method that one. First whatever the value original value this u into derivative of v log u now here v is x square minus 3 u is x so x square minus 3 log x this implies u by dx equal to x to the power x square minus 3 now here again we will use product rule so first is d by dx of x square minus 3 into log x plus x square minus 3 into d by dx of log x. So it is x to the power x square minus 3. Now the derivative of x square minus 3 is 2x into log x plus the x square minus 3 derivative of log x is 1 by x. Okay. So here it is, or you can write it as in this form. This you give question number 2. Okay. Then find d by dx. Now v. This is x minus 3 to the power x square. So dv by dx. The again whole function that is x minus 3 to the power x square into d by dx of v log u. Now here v is x square. U is x minus 3 so log x minus 3. This implies dv by dx equal to x minus 3 whole to the power x square. Again product rule. So first derivative of x square into log x minus 3 plus x square into derivative of log x minus 3 that is x minus 3 to the power x square and derivative of x square is 2x so 2x into log x minus 3 plus x square now at the derivative of log x minus 3 is 1 by x minus 3 into derivative of x minus 3 derivative of x minus 3 is 1 so this one you see dv by dx now you have got du by dx dv by dx now if you put these two values in 1 now what will you get now from 1 2 and 3 we get dy by dx equal to du by dx that means x to the power x square minus 3 into 2x log x plus x square minus 3 by x plus dv by dx 3x minus 3 to the power x square into 2x log x minus 3 plus x square by x minus 3. Okay. This is the now we'll solve next problem. Okay. It is direct find of derivative. Now another two question we'll solve proof. Type question. Question number 2. Question number 2. Right. to the power y equal to e to the power x minus y, then prove that dy by dx equal to log x by one plus log x equal to, sometimes it may be asked to find dy by dx. So proof is like, here already equation is given. So x to the power y equal to e to the power x minus y. Now you see both sides in exponent form. So here we will take logarithm first. So you can write log x to the power y equal to log e to the power x minus y. So this equal to right hand side log x to the power y from y log x, that is x minus y log e, which is same as x minus y, here is log e is equal to 1. So we have got the log x to the power y is equal to x minus y. Now log x to the power y is again written as y log x equal to x minus y. Here we have to prove that dy by dx is log x by 1 plus log x plus. Now how we will get this term 1 plus log x? Now here we see, if these two will be taken on the same side, y log x plus y, you take this minus y to left hand side, equal to x. Now y is common, that is log x plus 1, this factor we got, equal to x. Now take x on both sides, one side. So y equal to x by 1 plus log x. Now we will differentiate. This implies dy by dx equal to d by dx of x by 1 plus log x. Now we will use quotient rule. So it is 1 plus log x into dx by dx minus x into d by dx of 1 plus log x whole divided by 1 plus log x whole square. Okay. Now this equal to 31 plus log x minus x into t1 by x by 1 plus log x whole square. So here x has cancelled. So this equal to 1 plus log x minus 1 by 1 plus log x whole square. So plus 1 minus 1 cancel, and it is only log x by 1 plus log x whole square. This is the proof. Okay. Now next question, question number 3. Right, if x to the power p into y to the power q equal to x plus y equal to the power p plus q, so that dy by dx equal to y by x. So it is given x to the power p into y to the power q equal to x plus y to the power p plus q. Now here you see both sides in exponent form. Here we can take log. So this implies log x to the power p into y to the power q equal to here log x plus y to the power p plus q. Now I log of logarithm. That is log x to the power p plus log y to the power q. Right hand side will be p plus q. Log x plus y. Now again we can simplify left hand side log x to the power p. P log x. Similarly second is q log y. Equal to p plus q. Into log x plus y. Now we will differentiate it. Okay. Now differentiate it. Both sides with respect to x. We get either you will write d by dx of this on both sides or you can write in one differentiating. So if you will write it one, then no need to give derivative symbol. Direct you can use the form. So p is constant, it will be taken outside. So derivative of log x is 1 by x, so it will be p by x plus derivative of log y 1 by y into implicit function dy by dx. So it is q by y into dy by dx. Now right hand side p plus q is constant, so it will be taken like this. P plus q. Now derivative of log x plus y. First it will be 1 by x plus y log x into again derivative of x plus y. So this implies p by x plus q by y dy by dx equal to p plus q by x plus y. Now it is derivative of x is 1 and derivative of y is dy by dx. Now open the bracket. So it is p by x plus q by y dy by dx is plus q by x plus y plus p plus q by x plus y into dy by dx. Now we want to prove the value of dy by dx, so we want to find that. So keeping dy by dx on one side, that is q by y minus p plus q by x plus y whole into dy by dx. You take this term to left hand side. Equal to p plus q by x plus y minus p by x. This term you take to right hand side. Now here what will be the LCM y into x plus y. Now after multiplication it is qx plus qy minus py minus qy. So plus qy minus qy cancel all into dy by dx equal to right hand side LCM is x into x plus y. So it will be px plus qx minus px minus pi here plus px minus px cancel. Now from both side denominator this x plus y I also cancel. Now left hand side is qx minus py by y whole into dy by dx equal to right hand side is qx minus py by x. Again you see numerators are same, qx minus py, qx minus py. So these two are again cancelled. So this implies dy by dx equal to, now this y will be taken to the right hand side, it will be multiplied y by x. This is the proof. Okay. Now next number question is if y equal to root x to the power root x to the power root x up to infinity, then prove that x into dy by ds equal to y square by 2 minus y log x. Now prove the line. So here it is y equal to root x to the power root x to the power root x up to infinity. Now this type of problem we have already solved in correct. So here if you remove one or two root x from downward, then also you will get something. So you can write it as root x to the power y. Root x means x to the power 1 by 2 to the power y, means it is x to the power y by 2. Now it is exponent form. So taking log on both sides, log y equal to log x to the power y by 2, which is same as y by 2 log x. Now you take these two to this side, you can write 2 log y equal to y log x. Then we will differentiate. So d by dx of 2 log y equal to d by dx of y log x. This implies it is 2 by y into dy by dx equal to the dy by dx product into log x plus y into d by dx of log x. So it is log x dy by dx plus y by x. Now you want to prove dy by dx. So you keep dy by dx this side. So 2 by y minus log x whole into dy by dx equal to right hand side only y by x. Okay. Now, here if we take the LCM, this is 2 minus y log x by y into dy by dx equal to y by x. Here, this implies dy by dx equal to u cross multiply y into y t y square by x into 2 minus y log x. Now x we don't record this side, so again you cross multiply, take x to this side, so it will be x dy by dx equal to y square by 2 minus y log. So this is the proof of this. Now students, here I have solved this 4 plus in question number 1 itself 4 questions are there. So 8 problems I have solved. I'm logarithmic with differentiation, how to differentiate. Then go through this video, practice these questions. It may contain some of your textbook question also. And along with this, I will share the PDF of solution of important questions of exercise 5.5 of your textbook. Okay. That will be sent in PDF form. So first you try to solve exercise 5.5 yourself. Then if you will face any problem, then you can refer that solution part. And in solution also, if you will not be able to follow any step, then you are free to ask. Okay. In the next class, we will discuss about the derivative of a function with respect to another function and derivative of parametric function. Okay.